Hello and welcome to DCP. We'll solve this problem using unit load method, and this is our primary structure. As you can see, we need to find the M0 equation first for primary structure. So M0 equation for the primary structure. You can take a section at X, but since this is a semicircular beam hence for these kinds of beams, that is circular, semicircular or quarter circular, it is easier to work with polar coordinates rather than Cartesian coordinates. So this x and y can be expressed in terms of r and theta, right? So x is equal to r sine theta, isn't it? M0, basically here we have this M0 equation. So M0 will be equal to minus W into X, which is equal to minus W R sine theta, right? So we found our M0 equation. Now we need to find the M1 equation. So we remove all the loading and we apply a unit load at the point where we require the deflection. Same thing here. This is the unit load structure. M1 equation will be equal to minus 1 into x, which is equal to minus 1 into r sine theta. Now there is one more term in our formula, integration of a to b m0 m1 dx upon ei. So if you see, we have converted m0 in terms of theta, r and theta. We have converted m1 in terms of r and theta, but still this dx is not yet converted. So what is dx? Dx is basically small parts of your entire beam. Okay, these small parts are called as dx. So let's say there's a small part here, dx, and it subtends an angle of d theta here. Okay. Let this angle be equal to d theta. So from the arc formula, I can write dx is equal to r d theta. Okay, subtended arc formula, we can write that. And now we can substitute in this formula, delta is equal to, now our parameter is theta. Okay, theta is traveling. So when theta equal to 0, your theta is 0, and then it has to travel 180 degrees, or it is equal to pi, right, pi radians. So theta will be equal to 0 to pi. M0 is what? M0 is minus W R sine theta. Into M1 equation is minus R sine theta. Into dx is R d theta. Divided by EI. So it is equal to W into R cube upon EI, integration of 0 to pi sine square theta d theta, right? Sine square theta d theta. So sine square theta can be converted into cos theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2 into d theta. This integration going from 0 to pi. So it is equal to W R cube upon 2 EI theta minus sine 2 theta divided by 2 going from 0 to pi. And we get this as equal to, W R cube upon 2 EI, and when we put the limits, this pi minus sine 2 pi is 0, minus 0 minus 0, so it is pi by 2 W R cube upon EI. This is the equation for the deflection of this semicircular beam.